Hi, everyone, and welcome to Pennoni's What's Possible podcast, where we bring you compelling conversations with experts and thought leaders on the future of engineering and infrastructure. I'm your host, Bob McGee, Pennoni's Director of Marketing and Communications, and I'm super excited for our first episode today, where we're answering today's big question: what does it take to turn your engineering internship into an engineering career? So for that and more, we are speaking with Pennoni's President and CEO, Dave DeLizza. Before we get started, quick plug, don't forget to stay tuned after this episode to hear opportunities to work with us here at Pennoni. And now let's hear more from our guest. Welcome, Dave.
Thank you, Bob.
Thanks for joining us today. Appreciate the time. If you can, while we start here, just introduce yourself.
Yeah, I'm Dave DeLizza, President and CEO of Pennoni Associates. I'm a civil engineer by education, graduated from Drexel University in 1979, started as a Pennoni co-op in 1976.
Been here for a long time. A
few years.
If you can, tell us about your journey here at Pennoni.
I started as a staff engineer in the municipal division in 1979 after graduating from Drexel. And I've always found that my journey here, as you call it, has been constant learning and taking on new responsibilities as I became more involved in different projects. But when I look back, I had probably some of the best mentors that one could ask for in this business, including Chuck Pennoni and Rick Bacoli, Eric Flicker. I could probably name 20 different people here who helped me along the way. You start out in this business, you do one task on a job, a civil engineering job, let's say, and then you start to handle projects, handle people, handle clients. And that's really how my career here kind of developed. So I went from being a staff engineer. I got my engineering license in Pennsylvania in 1982. I was given the opportunity to handle two clients, the Township of Falls Authority and the Upper Southampton Authority. My responsibilities just increased. Eventually, I was taught by some people here, Stacy McPeak, Eric Flicker, how to look at the financials of the company, those types of things, so that I learned more and more. I always appreciated the fact that people were willing to teach, and as we are now, we have plenty of people here who are willing to teach our staff. It just gave me the opportunity to keep growing in the business.
That's great. So you talked a little bit about the Drexel Co-op. You started as a Drexel Co-op yourself. Can you talk a little bit about that program that obviously is still intact today?
Yeah, so, you know, we have a lot of good relationships with many of the universities across the country with the co-op and intern program. But the co-op program with Drexel is a six-month program. You have 3 6-month periods where you come into the office or in the field. I worked in the survey crews or in the field and work alongside engineers, surveyors, other professionals in the business, and you learn from them. So you go back to school, you're able to use those skills that you learned, and then you either come back to Pennoni like I did 3 times, or you go to another firm and learn from others. But it's just it's on-the-job training, which in engineering is probably one of the best things that you can do. It's different from other fields in that respect. So I think that's why the co-op and internship program here is great.
Yeah, I know it's a great program for us just because of the number of folks that are here even today that went through the exact same kind of journey that you did as a co-op, whether it's from Drexel or anywhere else. So obviously this is our first episode and it's the What's Possible podcast. Partners for What's Possible is a big thing for us here at Pennoni. It's our tagline. We put a lot into that. What's your opinion on that? What does that mean to you, that What's Possible tagline?
Well, you know, engineering as a profession is very interesting because you get to build things and you get to design things. And that's what we do here every day. And there's all kinds of great projects here in the city of Philadelphia where we're reusing properties. The Navy Yard's a good example. We're doing a lot of work down there. So the civil engineers have to be in tune with our clients' needs in order to help them achieve their goals for a successful project. And those projects could be small or they could be very large projects.
That partnership goes beyond clients. Pennoni, for a long time, and obviously still to this day, is very heavily involved in the communities, not only here locally in Philadelphia, throughout our footprint as a company. Can you talk a little bit about those partnerships with some of those community groups?
As a young staff engineer coming up at Pennoni way back when, Mr. Pennoni always, as part of our career development, talked to us about being involved in organizations outside of the company. And those were professional societies, civic organizations, religious organizations, business organizations like the Chamber of Commerce. And that was part of our career development. It's something we still do today with many of our staff. We want them to be involved. It's our opportunity to give back to the regions that we work in, whether it's donating our time or our dollars. Those are the things you have to do, make things better for everybody.
Sure. Can you elaborate a little bit on GIVE, right? So Pennoni GIVES is a program that we have here. Can you talk a little bit more about that?
Yeah, so Pennoni GIVES is a program we started a number of years ago, and we budget some dollars towards opportunities for our staff to get involved in outside organizations. If you want to give money to an organization that you work with, that group will have you submit an application and decide whether or not money can be given. The caveat here is that the employee has to be involved. They have to be a volunteer in that organization. We budget $25,000 a year. That's been very successful. And I think it's good for our employees. I think they appreciate the fact that's part of our give back program.
Yeah. I think it's really fantastic because you and I talk a lot about this. You tend to gravitate towards the industry specific organizations. And I know how much you value beyond that, right? Like you said, the Chamber of Commerce and a number of organizations that it really helps expand your network. I think it's really important. If we can, you talked a little bit early on, but I'm curious if you can give us a little more insight, maybe the first project that you worked on here at Pennoni.
Yeah, that was 1979 as an engineer when I joined the company. The first project I worked on was a water pumping station, and our client was the Bucks County Water and Sewer Authority. And they pumped water from Philadelphia up through Bucks County. And the pump station project at that time, it was a large project. It was like $1 million, which today is nothing with the prices of projects. But back then, that was a project we were working on. And I worked with Jimmy Klaus Fulborn, some others here, Ed McCorkle, as part of the design team for that. And my main task was to look at what they call water hammer, which is when the pumps kick off, the water comes back and could break the pipes. It's like your hot water heater at home. There's a expansion tank to help so you're not damaging your plumbing at your house. So that was my main task on that job. And then obviously designing the whole project and then bidding it and then seeing it through construction. So one of the things I like about how Pennoni does things is we're involved from the planning through the design phase, through permitting, and then during the construction, which is, for a civil engineer, is a great way to learn every aspect of the project. And that's what we've been doing for years.
So would you say that was the most interesting project that you've worked on, or does another one come to mind for you?
I worked down in Atlantic City for a number of years for Pennoni, running our Absecon, New Jersey office. Atlantic City was in a process of redevelopment, and I had the opportunity to work with the Casino Reinvestment Development Authority, was our client there. The whole entrance into Atlantic City was all redone. The roads were redone. There was all kinds of commercial development down there, outlet stores. So I would say that's probably my favorite project. I worked on that probably for 7 or 8 years total.
Yeah.
Yeah.
You still see that today?
Oh, yeah. Yeah.
So you gave us a little bit of insight here, how you got started at Pennoni and your journey here. Can you tell us a little bit more about that, your role, obviously, to where we are today in the boardroom?
I talked about my first project here, the opportunity to have clients and be able to grow my own part of the business. In the early 90s, I took over our Absecon, New Jersey office. We talked about Atlantic City. In my mind, was a civil engineer's dream. You had the boardwalk, traffic, the beach, all kinds of neat things to work on. The city was going through a lot of redevelopment with the casino money. I ran that office for a number of years, and then I was able to move to the Haddon Heights office in 1998. And ran that office. It was an opportunity to grow both locations. 2005, I became our strategic growth director, which is a job held today by Joe Viscuso. That gave me the opportunity to get involved more in client development, project development, as well as mergers and acquisitions. Again, that was an opportunity to keep learning from Eric Flicker and Stacy McPeak and the names I keep mentioning. 2014, I became the chief operating officer of the company. And I was in that job for about 5 years. And then in July 1st of 2019, I became president and CEO of the company. So it was a natural progression of increasing responsibilities, learning, getting out there, creating relationships. And that's how it happened. I don't think I did anything special. I just worked hard at it, you know?
And learned. Right? You say that all the time. Yeah. Learn something new every day. So Dave, you talked a little bit about how you got involved here, obviously Pennoni and your start. But if we could take a step back a little bit more, how did you get involved in engineering?
I was always interested in math and science, and I happened to be good at that stuff. And that came from when I was about 10 years old. My dad worked for the city of Philadelphia, and he was working on two bridges, the Spring Garden Street Bridge and the Girard Avenue Bridge. And this is like the mid-60s. And he would take me out during construction, like on a Saturday morning, and show me how the bridges are built, the steel's all out there, and it was pretty cool to see all that. And also, he had a side job where he was doing house designs for some redevelopment projects down in South Philadelphia. So we had a drafting table set up in our house, and he would design. Back then, you didn't use computers for design. It was all hand drawing. I just gravitated towards that, thought it was pretty cool. Again, having math and science being strong there, it just took me right to that field. I liked building things or seeing things built, and that's how I kind of got there.
That's pretty cool. All right, so staying on the topic of projects, we're sitting here in the boardroom at Pennoni. That there's a number of iconic projects on the wall. That's certainly something that, as we look back through our history, is pretty cool to see. Most recently here, 2024 was a great year for us. 2025, just talk if you can some of the projects that we've worked on over the past year and maybe to come, and really what excites you about that.
Our biggest project would probably be the I-95 CAP project, which is currently under construction. That was designed by Deb Farrar, Jim Pizzotti, and team here in our transportation division, as well as many others throughout the company. That was about a $300 million project. Currently under construction, it was a design build. It's a great site that they're trying to change the waterfront and add some things. There's going to be a park on top later on in the project. There are other great projects in addition to the Eds and Meds that we work with. Our work down at the Navy Yard and also down at the old PES site, which is being redeveloped by Hilco. And our civil engineers here in Philadelphia are working on that. It's a 1,300-acre site in the city of Philadelphia, which is crazy when you think about it. But that was the site of that refinery. And there's a lot of environmental work to be done. And then to rebuild and change the use of that site, you know, for economic reasons, we have a developer, Hilco, who's a great client of ours working on that. And that's another project that's 5+ years in the making.
Yeah. Yeah, it's great to be a part of those transformational projects. We've done a number of those over the years, and it's great to see where that'll take us in the future. So speaking of the future and that journey, where do you see Pennoni in the future?
We're an employee-owned company. We want to keep growing our business. So I see us staying as an employee-owned company. That was one of our goals in our strategic plan a number of years ago, was to stay 100% employee-owned. There's opportunities for growth. The three best markets for engineers are transportation, water, wastewater, and power. We're working in all those markets, so there's growth opportunity there. There's a lot of merger and acquisition opportunities that come to us through staff, through outside brokers who know our business. So there's opportunity to grow there. When I started at Pennoni in 1976, the company was 43 people. So now we're 1,400. So I've been able to find opportunities with that growth. And that's one of the reasons you grow, right? You want to give people the opportunity to grow their career.
Obviously, with that growth comes opportunities for careers, right? We know right now, and maybe you can talk a little bit more about it, the number of openings that we have here at Pennoni. Can you talk about that, the openings, the journey of what that looks like for any potential candidate?
So just like every other engineering business across the country right now, we're all experiencing a shortage of talented staff to do the work. Right now we have, last time I looked, I think it was about 170 job openings on Pennoni.com, our careers page. But as I talk to other CEOs and other firms in our business, we're all experiencing the same thing. Not enough engineers coming out of school. There's opportunity there. If you want to come and learn and give us an opportunity, there's surveying opportunities, there's environmental, all kinds of engineering openings. It's a good spot to take a look if you're interested in an engineering job.
Yeah. Can you expand a little bit on that? I think it's really interesting. We talked about growth. We talked about the firm and the transformation of the firm, right? In the last 10+ years, we've grown significantly geographically through mergers and acquisitions. So those openings are pretty spread out, right? It's not just local here in Philadelphia.
Yeah, so we have 40 offices, as you know. So yes, those openings are all over the company from Boston down to Florida, out to Pittsburgh. So yes, there's plenty of openings geographically. We do our best to have the young people who worked with us as interns or co-ops. If they like us and we like them, it's a good opportunity for them to keep coming back and then eventually to land a full-time position here. I know we've just hired a couple. I know there's one over in Rowan that worked with us young lady, Grace Carey, who we just hired as a full-timer, and there's others. They can learn from us, they can join us, keep learning, and see where it takes them in their career. But there's two sides of the story. We can help them, we can push them, they got to do the work too, right?
Sure.
Not only are there engineering positions, there's all kinds of positions open here.
Yeah.
We're an engineering firm, there's all kinds of support positions, right? There's accounting, there's your group, corporate communications, there's HR, there's all kinds of things that people can do here,
sure.
Not just engineering.
Yeah. We've had a number of folks in my group here that have done an internship with us or a co-op and have stayed on managing relationships, developing those. They're beyond the industry itself, it's community organizations, it's chamber of commerce, it's things that you dedicate your time.
Oh, look, every business is people, and people create relationships with each other. We've had relationships with people, I think of the Lower Merion Township, we've been there for over 50 years.
Yeah.
Other municipal accounts that we have, where you create those relationships, where people, not only are they clients, they become family friends.
Yeah.
And it's a good way to go, because again, there are people that you can learn from, you know what to expect, what they want from you, and you deliver, you know, you develop a relationship that can help you in your career, and obviously it helps the company.
Yeah, that's great. Well, Dave, we appreciate the time today. I wanted to cover, if we can, just a couple of quick takeaways from our chat. Learning is a critical point, right? Never stop learning. You say that all the time, and I think that's a really important thing for anyone out there, quite frankly. Internships, a great opportunity. You can come on board, you can grow your career. And lastly, which I think is really important, the ability to get out there and get involved and meet folks to expand that network, especially for someone who's maybe younger in their career. Dave, thanks for your time today. We really appreciate it. Thanks for joining us for our first episode. I want to remind everyone to follow us on our social channels. Stay tuned for our next episode. It'll feature our CIO, Marcus Widener, as well as Joe Viscuso, Head of Strategic Growth. A big focus on how technology will change the engineering industry. Dave, thanks for the time. We appreciate it. Thanks, everybody, for tuning in today. I'm Bob McGee, your host. Look forward to you joining us next time.